Hello and welcome back once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod from Gideon Seymour. At the end of the last quest, I had a problem with the flight potion, so I made another one, and then I could actually then finish the quest. I don't really understand what the problem was, but it just seemed to disappear away. And I've been busy making imbued slates and all sorts of things. Because what I'd like to do today is just finish off the next quest or in the chain here and then start to upgrade the altar. So I think I've got this usual one to open and finish. Let's quickly do that. Have a look at the bag. Probably something been fairly useless recently, but just like that one. So we can get rid of those three, don't need any of those. Put the diamond away, we've got 9 diamonds, that's going up quite nicely. And notch apple we can put in here. So what I plan to do is to, let's finish this, let's do the quest first, that's supposed to be the best thing to do. Right click. So head first for halos. And open the quest. So the next thing we've got to do, if I can see it, I think it's this one, droning on. We've got to make a programming puzzle. So let's go and find out how we make a programming puzzle. Not there, because this is full. In fact, what I've got this was prepared for is to make some ritual stones. Let's take those ritual stones away. So I've got, should have 88. What I'm planning to do is takes a lot of ritual stones. So now we want to make a programming puzzle. A puzzle, probably a good one. It's this one I think we have to make. A start. So here we need a printed circuit board and 8 green plastics, which are made from repulsion plant seeds. So I think I might have some of those prepared in here. Yes, I have. Repulsion plant, and I've even got a printed circuit board. We made those last time, so you saw me do that. So this time, what I'd like to do is do the same thing, make sure that the signal of magnetization is turned off, put one of those in there, and put the rest in the hopper. So that should then open up. I can look in the window here. In fact, it looks like to me those plastic sheets are already made. So turn on the signal of magnetization, and here we have the 8 we need. Let's come back in here and allow that as one of the outputs. I forgot to do the one last time, doesn't matter very much. So let's have a look what we got to do with this one. So we just simply spread these around a PCB, and we get 8 4 start puzzles. Let's go back to the quest book. So now I've got that one. I goddamn thing. Well, we've got to make one drone. Okay, now the recipe for a drone is similar, I guess. There we go. So this will be an unpressured one and a pressured one. So we need another printed circuit board and 4 turbines. Now the printed circuit board is a block of redstone in an altar. Right. And I don't have any blood in the altar at the moment. Let's just make sure this is turned off. So I don't want it draining as it's working along, so just turn this off. That will do. The switch doesn't seem to work there, but sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Generate some blood. I'm not sure how much we need for this, actually. Let's have a look. Let's put the block of redstone in the hopper. And you'll notice I've done a few other things while I'm here, actually. We'll look at those in a second. Just first of all, we need a bit more blood in the altar. We've got a baby shoot him maybe. Yes. I think it goes faster that way. You're not going to get any blood from him anyway, so. A lot of mobs. They're not coming down, probably. Maybe because of the spiders up there. I suppose we've got a load of junk in here as well, which we have. Whoa. Another spider. Can it spiders? Yes. Right, good. There looks like about three of them. No, just the two. I don't want that for the time being. And put those in there. Like that. Sort the chest. Press escape. And because you can't sort it on when you're actually looking at the hopper. So you have to only sort it when you're not looking at the hopper. So we've got some more bones that I don't want, and some more armor. I'll just put those in here as well. For the time being. And that looks good. So now we should have plenty of blood in the altar by the looks of it. So nearly 40,000. So let's take out of there the orb and let that process. So what you may have noticed, this is all flat, but the altar is still a tier 3 altar. And what I've done is I simply filled it in. I didn't expect it to work. If we go down here, we can have a quick look. I filled it in, and these ruins are still working underneath, which is great. So it makes life for me much easier, and I'm not having so many problems. I was having problems with the altar before because of the this corner here. If I stood here, the mobs could see me. Now they can't see me because it's just this extra one block. What I did is I tidied up the stuff too, so I took everything out of the things and just put them into the. These some gold chests here. You can see this level of stuff we get from the mob grinding. So I can just basically look at this, it's already nearly full. We won't do that in a minute, we're going to have some respiration one. Quite a lot of stuff in there as well. Could take some of this stuff out, we won't for the time being, got plenty of time. So here is the new altar, the build for the new altar. Oops. Yes, didn't mean to do that. Let's get up and have another look at that. See, what I was planning to do was to make some more stones of augmentation. Ah, I can't get up so easily. I need a bit more space. Let's do it over here. I think I've got more room over here. Yes, I have. All right. Oh yes, that's right, I was going up here, but I went up the wrong side. I should have gone up the sides here. Because I've got these all cut out for the time being. Because what I'm going to put into here is the augmentation, capacity augmentation runes. And here we've got all of the runes around here for the tier 4 altar. But first of all, let's just make sure we do the one thing at a time. So, my printed circuit board is nearly ready. It's the it's just an unassembled PCB at the moment. Nobody in there, I just have to wait for this. In fact, I can eat while I'm waiting, of course, the usual thing. Shouldn't be too long, I don't know how long it'll be, but anyway, I don't need to worry, look at it. While it's doing this, I can just do something else. So one of the things I want to make, two rituals, but first of all, I'm a bit further away. Let's have a look up here, again. What I haven't done is showed you the top. This is where the mob spawn is going to be. And you'll see basically what I've got is a big flat surface here, which is actually the size of the tier 5 altar. the tier 5 altar I've marked out in white here. Actually, just that's why it's done. Here I'm going to do it 5 high, and in the middle, which is here, I'm going to put 2 rituals. The first ritual, let's have a look what rituals I've got planned, is this one, the ritual of regeneration. And that requires, if I can calculate this correctly, 44 stones plus a master ritual stone. So that means 48 ritual stones for that. And the other one I want to do is the Well of Suffering. Now, I can only do one of these at a time because I don't mean that. I mean, I can only do, if I shift, let's click the Well of Suffering. I don't have the activation crystal for the ritual of regeneration, but where is it now? It's actually the one before this one, the Well of Suffering. And the Well of Suffering I need, that looks like 36 ruins plus the 4 for the master ritual. So I'll need 40 for that. That's where I've got this 84 from. So what I'll do is I'll put a roof, and then on top of the roof here, I'll just do this, what I've got here, some slabs, like before, so you don't see. No, it doesn't need any torches up there, so it's quite safe from. Oops. In fact, I haven't pressed F7 yet. Let me just press F7. Because I haven't got that turned on. Now, this is always difficult to get down this, actually. What you have to do is you have to walk forward till you go over the edge, and then press S and missed it, and go backwards. Right, now we have a printed circuit board. So let's go and get that. Just check. I'll put the master ritual back in. We don't need any bones in there. Turn off this, don't need that either. Right, so we need to make a drone. So now we need to make these turbines, and if you remember, we need 4 of these, so that means I need 12 turbine blades. Turbine blades, gold and redstone in the compression chamber. So we need, what did I say, 12. So I need 24 of these, so we split that into 2. And we need 12 gold. I've only got 10 there. Let's get another 2 from over here. And let's put those into the pressure chamber. Actually, the pressure chamber is turned off, but the pressure is still good. So it's actually, even though it's turned off, you see the gold's now in there. There's enough pressure in there to process these into blades. There we go. Look. Plenty, I think they're all finished now. Let's turn on our sickle and let's come over here this time and actually mark that as one of the outputs. Right, turn off the sickle again. That's a long way around. So we now need some compressed iron, which I've got steel. Ah, no, I left it in the. I've got any there. I left it in the chest back here. I need 4, don't I? Take 12 just to be safe. Don't want to keep running backwards and forwards. So it was the same thing as that. So we need. In fact, it's probably easiest to do it like this. If you just left drag, you know, you get your 4 rotor blades. That's probably the easiest way. So now we needed. Can't remember the pattern. Let's just have a look. Yes. Okay. And we have our drone. So now let's have a look at the book. Completed. So now we can claim a reward. We've got either 2 or 1. I don't know. Let's take the 1. There must be something special about it. We get 16 golden apples, a full heart, and 2 drone and 1 drone. Let's have a look. What have we got for drone? Ah, that's a pressurized drone. This is an unpressurized drone. That's what I thought might be the case. So take the heart. Got the heart eaten. 22 lives remaining. Great stuff. Now, what else do I want? Maybe we can put one of those drones on this chamber here. And on this charging station, I've actually got some upgrades in the helmet. If I look at the inventory on there, I put in the one I got, which was the item search helmet. It makes all sorts of strange noises and does all sorts of strange things. So let's just take it off and put in the one with no pressure in it and let that get pressured up. Do you want to see what happens on this one when you put it on? Oops. Makes all sorts of strange noises and telling you what things aren't installed and so on and so forth. Initialization complete. So I was searching for a lava signal last time and didn't find any. If we could actually search again, I think you have to press F, but it's a bit strange because it overlaps the map. So what you can do, I think you have to do that from the inventory here. Let's turn off the O to get rid of that, and I think it might be F. No, it can't be. Oh, yes, it is F for the helmet options. So I've got this item search upgrade installed. And you can search for an item and you can do things like move things around, move stat screen. That's this one. We could move this a bit out of the way so it doesn't get in the line of the map. So, for example, that will do it. Back to game. This time it's well away from the map, so we actually could put it back again. But to be honest with you, I'm not going to use it for the time being. So I'll put it over here in this chest. And with the drone as well, we don't really want those today. Maybe I just need to find out what to do with them. That might be the might be the point of it. Right, and in fact, let's put away this as well. Right, good. I didn't put away the start. Did I put it in here? Yes, I did. Let's put away the start piece as well. Right. That's completed. Let's have a look at the next quest while we're here, because that's really the purpose, isn't it? So we've got to do this autonomy. And here I have to make all sorts of pneumatic assembly controllers, lasers, and all the rest of it. So I'll do that later on. I'm not ready for that yet. I'll need to research how to do it and what I do with them. In the meantime, let's get on with this. Some more mobs around, so we need to fill up our blood supplies. And, as it happens, I need to also do this. Turn this back on because we've not got very much blood in the pipes at the moment. Oops, wrong weapon. Go away for a few seconds and you can get quite a lot, don't we? There's a little. No, there isn't. I thought there was a baby zombie there somewhere. Dropping a lot of things as well. Got him in the end. And then we put the junk back into the harbour. Right. So what I wanted to make, and you've seen me do this before, were some runes. So let's turn on the NEI again. I want to make this one. So I need lots of buckets and stone. So I only need to make 10, I think it was. So let's do 10. I haven't got enough in here, but I need to get some more stone. And we need lots of buckets. We've got 13 buckets, that's not enough. We can start with those though, and make some more buckets. And we need some more stone, don't we? So I need buckets and stone, right? We should have plenty of iron in here, and stone is round the back. So we put, actually I can put the whole of that thing on there. Buckets, let's just go to the other crafting table. I think it's empty at the moment. No, it isn't. This one is actually a rather useful ruin I was going to make. In fact, let's go and get that because I need the master blood orb as well for this. So I'll take that out of there and remove the blood orb. Leave the mobs for the time being. I think it's a magician blood orb I need for this. And I get the sigil of the Phantom Bridge. This is a really cool sigil. And you just turn it on and you just walk. It makes a bridge. The bridge stays there for a little bit of time. So maybe that'll help. So I turn it off because it uses a LP, so to speak, from the network. And you can actually go uphill as well with this one. I think you just jump. I'll put him over there. And what did I want to do? Oh, yes, buckets. And I made another ender lily seed. How many buckets do we need? 21. It's probably too many. Let's make 15. That 16 is a stack, isn't it? That makes 16. Come round here. Probably should have counted how many buckets I wanted to start with, didn't I? Oh, I need one more. Typical. I put the master blood orb in the middle and I should be able to get these runes of augmented capacity. Let's just make the last bucket and get all 10 and then put them into the altar. In fact, having used up my existing buckets, I probably should have been sensible to make some more, wouldn't it? So now I have 10 of these. Let's go and put these into the altar for two reasons. One, so I don't fall down again, and two, because then it's going to finish it off. So I put it here on the edge. If I put it on the other bit, that's fine. If I put it on these, it'll do some strange things to them, because those are the, I've got my jetpack on, I don't need that either. Right, so now the altar is now complete, except we need to do the glowstone, and we need the next bit for the tier 4 altar. Glowstone, have I got glowstone prepared? Yes, I've got... I need 4 glowstone, which will make the tier 3. So let's do that first of all. I'll turn on this as well. And I'm simply going to knock these off here. In fact, because this is glowstone, I don't need to put a torch on top of it. Right, that should now be a tier 3 altar. Let's check. Oh, get to a place where I can actually see the altar would be a good place. So now it's tier 3. Now to tier 4 we've got to change these white blocks here, because the rest of it's already done. In this particular case I've got runes of sacrifice all the way around. And what we need for that are those blood shards. And if you remember, the blood shards and one piece of stone actually come from... I only need one blood shard and one piece of stone. You'll see what I did. I was putting the carpenter's blocks with coloured bricks white, and the recipe for the colour brick white were just basically a paintbrush and some bone meal around stones, and you get these one for one, as it were. So, but I just need an ordinary piece of stone, which hopefully I've got one in here. But no, I have. Look at that. Amazing. So we just craft those two together. I knew I had more than that. I think it's like this. And then we get some large bloodstone bricks. And that's all I have to put up there. And then it'll become a tier 4 altar. Let's go and do that. In fact, yes. I was going to think about how do I get up there. It's actually awkward because they are quite high, but I do have a jetpack and I think I can reach anyway. Yes, I can. Look, and then I can simply press it on there because I'm hitting the floor of the mob spawner, which I can see. Neat, huh? And I don't need any torches on top of that. So that should be it. Now we should have a tier 4 altar. Let's have a look. Hopper. Tier 4 altar, isn't that fantastic? So here I've got some blood prepared to put into this tank. So all I've got a switch here, so I want to turn it on. So let's get the blood into the altar. And this blood should go into the altar a lot faster than it was doing before. Is it on? Yes. Probably takes a few seconds before that starts to work. There's no... why is the blood not going in there? Let's just try removing this. Let's remove these two and try that again. Let's put the resonant portable tank on top of this. Fortunately, you can't see it going up or down. Well, that should feed blood into the altar. Why is it not doing? Well, that's a puzzle. Let's just change this so it's not a signal. Just ignore it. So therefore, it should go in even if it's coloured wrong. That's a nuisance. Ah, there we go. Now you see it's coming in at a reasonable rate. It's around about, well, it's hard to say actually. It's about 150 per tick. So what we now need to do is we need two more. I need to upgrade this diviner here. The one I need to upgrade it for is dusk stones. So we need to do the upgrade. So let's have a look at what we need to do for that. So we need two demonic slates, and they are 15,000 in a tier 4 altar with an imbued slate. Fortunately, I've got some imbued slates. And what's the other thing I needed? I'll try and have a look again. It was some... elementary inscription tools, dusk, which is a block of coal in an altar with 2000 LP. Now that's not too difficult either, because I've got blocks of coal. So we've got two slates, we want those two, they're imbued. And we want two blocks of coal, that's obsidian. And I think I prepared that and put it in here. Look at that. That's what we need. The block of coal actually came from the nether. I got some when I was killing the nether skeletons. I got quite a lot of coal and just turned it into block. But there is a way to make this anyway. You can look at the recipe for this. All you have to do is to put, I think it's charcoal, in a blood altar tier 2 with a 1000 LP. You get coal. So you can always make it if you can't, if you don't want to go to the nether. Look at that. Oops. That's a shame. I lost his blood. He usually gives me plenty of blood. Anyway. Have I got this turned on? Yes. Right, let's go back to our exercise. Now we may have enough blood in this altar. 15,000. That's enough for the elementary inscription tools. That was clever, and I should have emptied this out before I started. What's this one I want, isn't it? So let's put that one. The other was 25,000. Position 5. Okay. I'll put those into the hopper here. And they should appear in here if everything's working. That's the same problem as last time. Let's take those out of there. Let's go and dump the stuff I've got in here because I don't need all of this. Let's have a look. What have we got in? Arrows, great. Bones. I think that looks like about it. I put some junk in this one up here, but I'll put this one in there for the time being. Yes. So let's just break this, put it back on again. And put the coal back in it, see if it disappears. Block of coal. That's strange. Okay, let's do it the old fashioned way. That was quick. That was quicker than I expected, actually. Let's try this one. In fact, you do need to be careful with this, because the reason you need to be careful with it, if I look for the usage, how's that? It's only the usage in there, but it will actually turn into something else if you leave it in too long. Well, that was good. So the next one was demonic slates. Let's have a look. 25,000 I've got in. So I just put in one of these two. I wonder if it just blocks the coal that the hopper doesn't like. Nope, seems to be general. Let me have a look what's wrong with the hopper. Ah, I wonder if it's the switch. Uh-oh, don't want to do that, actually. It was a switch. That was very bad. Because I don't have enough blood in here for two of them. Just put one of them in here. In fact, I've got another 8k of blood. Let's put that on top of it. The fluid tank. Uh-oh, that's what I was worried about. So I need to do a bit of self sacrifice it. If I've got enough blood in here, I've got a golden apple but not a notch apple. I have to go and get a notch apple very quickly, and hopefully I can rescue this. Yes, you see, it's not quite gone yet. Right, let's eat this. Let's get this going. Try not to do it too fast. Run it completely out of health, like last time. Looks like it's already turned into demonic slate. but that's one more time. So what's needed is 15,000. Let's have a look how much have I got in here. One looks like a demonic slate indeed. Yes it is, perfect. Let's get some food into myself because I won't recover until I do. And let's have a look at this. 25,000, perfect. So we can actually put the next one in. I need the imbued slate. Now I need to get back to the hopper for that one, since it's now working. And you can turn it off with the switch. I learned something today, how about that? Phew. I really should have cleaned out my inventory first as well. So you see it does go very fast now with the speed runes which are around here. So you're already done. So now what I can do with this, get my food in here actually so I can eat. Let's put away this stuff I don't really want. Right, good. And we can now upgrade this. Now if I remember rightly, it's two of these. I think they go, it's either this side or that side, I never remember which. Let's have a look. Yes, we are. So now we have a ritual stone that can do dusk stones, which is the really important one. So now what we're going to do, I've got this hateful particle effect from the regen, or the fire resistance I've got. So let's go and set up these two. Have I got them with me? Yes, I have. Nope, I haven't quite ready. I need two. I'll do this very quickly because I've got just about run out of time, but I need two master ritual stones. One. So I need the magician's orb. Obsidian, I actually have plenty of. Right. So now let's go over here. The right direction, of course. Come up here. And in the middle of here, we're going to set down the two master ritual stones. Because they interleave with each other. So put down the wrong one. This one. So put down the bottom one and the top one. Now the top one is going to be the Well of Suffering, but I don't know whether these are going to interfere. Probably will do. Let's just remove these two items. Probably not so easy. Yes, I've got my gravity gun. Good. Let's just I don't know whether this will work either, but let's just try moving the chest. Oh, I can put him over here, look. Oops, he's just dropped down somewhere daft. Probably inside the... And this one we can chop up. Right, good. So now we take this one, which we've got now the Well Ritual, is the Well of Ritual Full Spring. We don't want that one. We want the Ritual of... the Well of Suffering, this one. And all we have to do is to right-click the top, this middle one. It'll start to put down the stones for us. And I keep doing this until it's finished. That looks fairly good. But I might need to put some torches. No, I don't need to put torches on this. Have I got F7 pressed? I have, good. Now that's put down those there. And on the bottom side, we're going to do the same thing. This time we want the next one, the Ritual of Regeneration. This is the one I can't activate. So I hold this one down here on the bottom one. It should be putting down stones on the outside. because I believe these two fit together. I've never done it. That doesn't look right. Something must be in the way. Maybe a torch to just get rid of these for the time being. Hopefully that's not too small either. I didn't check the size. Oops, I can't get through that. Nope, that's not working. But it has put down some stones. Tell you what we'll do. Let's quickly remove this stuff over here. Pickaxe is quite fast. Just in case this is in the way, because it won't work if something's in the way. Trying to get in again. I hope there's nothing to do with these torches. Right, right click again. It's not going green. And I've still got 23 stones to put down. I think it's put some down. That's strange. Well, what I'm going to do, I'll get rid of all those torches now. I've got it on the right ritual, haven't I? Ritual of Regeneration, yes. Okay, I think I don't have to do it first either. I think you can do it one after the other. Or maybe these are in the way. You never know. So I think it's a fairly flat one, this one, so... I won't waste too much more time on this. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Right, okay. One last thing to do is to activate this thing. Yes, there is. That makes more sense now. I've got that lit. Let's just fly down and do that in a quick way. And my weak activation crystal is here. In fact, this will, in fact, if I'm not mistaken, has a range. It's supposed to be 10 by 10, but I think it's a lot bigger than that. So what I have to do here is to simply activate this. I'm supposed to just right-click it, and there you go, it's bubbling. And you can already hear things are popping. Those are actually what you can hear is bats. The bats are definitely dying. So it's actually reaching. I didn't supposed to be able to reach this. Where are those torches here? I want to make sure that I don't have mobs spawning up here and dropping down. That wouldn't be great at the moment. At least until I've got the wall set up, that is. How are we doing? Just those end pieces there. Yes. Right, and that's it. I will finish off this assembly and I shall see you next time. Until then, bye for now.